Hey now, Rodney Erdickson here, reporting that the presence of an up-to-date Google Play Services app on your Android 4 and up device will greatly assist in reducing the battery consumption of your Android device. So essentially, you'll have much more battery autonomy if you have the Google Play Services app present on your Android device, as well as being up-to-date, of course. Now, this is regardless if you use Google's location network location awareness, regardless if you use the GPS technology of your Android device. This is regardless if you use Wi-Fi, regardless if you use Bluetooth, regardless if you use your device with a connection to your cellular service provider. Essentially, I performed tests both with Android devices, both with nothing installed and nothing running. Both Android devices were the same make and model, relatively the same age, relatively had the same amount of use on them. Both were being used as video cameras to record for 2-hour periods. Both were being used concurrently in the same environment at the same time. The only difference was that one of the two had Google Play services installed and up to date. The other one did not. In the end of the recording sessions, the device that had Google Play services installed had a lot more battery reserve than the device that did not have Google Play services installed. When I then updated Google Play services to the device that did not have it, on subsequent recording tests, where once again recording for the same amount of time, same duration, on two devices of the same make and model, I noticed that my battery consumption levels after the end of the 2-hour recording sessions were similar, instead of one device having much less battery power reserve than the other. And I attribute it to the presence of Google Play services. Now, if you, when in your Android device, Android 4 and up, in settings, under apps, if you do not have Google Play services, you can download and install it from the Google Play Android market. The problem is, generally, you cannot find Google Play services in the Google Play Android market, which I think is ridiculous. Generally, you have to receive a link in order to update Google Play services from the use of another app. Now, from my experience, it's been apps that use the Google's location awareness that will prompt you to update Google Play services. So anything that uses the GPS satellites and GPS positioning. So think of Google Maps, for example. I know Hangouts invites you to update Google Play services when you add the Hangouts dialer component to your Google Hangouts app. If you're at a loss and cannot find an app that will grant you access to Google Play services, I know two dating apps that do this. However, for both, you'll need a Facebook account and you'll need to bind the dating apps to your Facebook account. So I don't know how you feel about that. Maybe you want to try the Google offerings, such as Google Maps, Google Hangouts, plus Google Hangouts dialer first. And if that doesn't work, you can download either the Happn app, H-A-P-P-N, or the Tinder app. And upon installing, binding your Facebook account, and using for the first time, it should prompt you to install Google Play services. For example, the Happn app, it's H-A-P-P-N. You do a search for it, find it in the Google Play Android market. You download and install. Upon binding your Facebook account, hopefully you'll receive a message such as this: update Google Play services. Your geolocation won't run unless you update Google Play services. Upon which you tap on update, and of course, at which point you're brought to the store page for Google Play services. You can then install or update. It needs access to all this good stuff. Keep in mind that this is accurate as of this date of recording. This may change in the future. You accept, it installs, and then once it's installed, you could click open, but it tap, I should say, open, but it really doesn't make a difference. The goal is so that you see Google Play services present in your app section of your device. Keep in mind that Google Play services obviously clocks in rather heavy. It's just under 100 megs as of this date of recording. So if you have a device with low storage like mine, it may be a consideration that you have to keep in mind. Do you really want the benefit of having less battery consumption, but lose out on that much space? It's a trade-off. Regardless, I'll leave you with that. I hope this information helps, and as usual, all the best.